The CV90 was originally developed to meet the specific requirements of the Swedish Army, but since then it's evolved, and a whole family of vehicles have been built, and you've now over 1,200, and you're unveiling the latest Mark IV. Can you tell us a bit about the CV90 Mark IV, because it really is a step change in earlier vehicles?
Yeah, I would say the biggest changes are in its the new electronic architecture and the drivetrain, what we've done to that.
Yeah, and you've got still got a, what engine have you got? So got a Caterpillar or?
No, we still have a Scania, Scania V8, but we're currently putting in the latest platform, the DP platform on the Scania, which gives us a possibility to go up to 1,000 horsepower. We currently, the one we're qualifying is at 840 horsepower.
Yeah. And the track, have you got Susi tracks on it or conventional steel tracks?
You can go with both, you know. That's up to the customer, actually. The flexibility with the CV90.
I mean, I've driven CV90 with a rubber band track, and it is quieter, less vibration, and less rolling resistance, which gives you a better fuel economy. And I think the electronic architecture allows for easier plug and play and upgrade as new systems come available.
Yes, but the biggest change is the amount of real-time data we're able to crunch. We're talking teraflops in the data mining capabilities, which in terms makes us it makes it easy to upgrade with machine learning algorithms, artificial intelligence, sensor fusion, sensor data fusion, automatic decision support for the crew.
I think you also, last year, you showed some through the armor vision stuff, and that sort of stuff you could plug in if the customer wanted it.
Exactly. And the new architecture makes that easier and also makes it easier to present data with video without lag, since you have the computation capacities of the new electronic architecture.
The original Swedish one had a 40mm Bofors gun, but you are fairly flexible. In the new one, you can have a much wider range of armaments.
Yeah, with the new D series of turret, that's a much more flexible series of turret, where you can actually change the main gun compared or in terms of what the customer wants. So we currently have the 30/40mm super shot, the 35/50mm super shot. We can also have the 40mm CTAI and also 120mm guns in the same turret shell.
It's like remote weapon stations in some parts where the customer decides what he wants. He said, I want that vehicle with that weapon system. And you as a contractor have to work around that.
Exactly, and that's why we have built in this modularity or flexibility. We also have the gun pods, so we actually have the machine gun on the outside where you can change the pods to a 50 caliber 7.62 or a 40mm grenade launcher or a laser weapon if you'd like that.
We've got 7 customers for the CV90 now with some more in prospect.
Yes, I sure hope so. Yes, we do have 7 customers at the moment, and hopefully within a couple of years there will be. We have added that list to at least 2.
I think for the last 20 years, almost all of your production of the CV90 has been an export. But now you're upgrading some of the very old CV90s of the Swedish Army.
Yes, that's correct. The Swedish Army has 549 vehicles, and they're going into refurbishment, or I would say a life extension program. Yes, that's correct.
I mean, I looked at the Norwegian upgrade, and that was a really... And when I looked at the Swedish Army, it was slightly down.
In the long run, it comes down to budget. And that's a problem if you have a lot of units, of course. 549 vehicles are quite a lot, a lot more than the Norwegian have.
I know the CV90's got a good level of protection, but you've also actually could add an active protection system if the customer wanted it, and there are a number of options for that as well.
Yes, there is. I mean, the CV90 was the first vehicle in the world to have a deep integrated defensive aid suite, and now we're adding the next layer on top of that with a hard kill system, and that's being done with the Dutch customer.
Yeah, and how many hours of combat experience have you had in the vehicle? I should know, but
we have accumulated 70, actually more than 70,000 combat days or days in combat operations with 3 different users: Sweden, Norway, and Denmark. And I've been in Liberia, in Africa, with the Swedish Army, and in Afghanistan with all 3 of them.
Yeah, thank you much, Dan.